Hello and welcome back to Gears Workshop channel. If you're unfamiliar with what a sled is, or what it's used for, here are some details. A sled is a movable device that glides in and out of the table saw. The workpiece is then supported by a wooden barrier at the front of the sled, preventing sliding, and ensuring a clean, completely square cut every time. Begin with wood pieces the same size as the one you're looking at, and I'll teach you how to create it. The first step may not be essential at all. I only want to emphasize the workshop logo, to make it stand out more. I began by creating markers for dowel joints. It will make it easier and more precise, for me to assemble things, and enhance the stiffness. The miter saw looks to be the best instrument for cutting aluminum bars. I need to cut two little plywood slats to build the sled's bottom two sliders. Cutting such little items is quite risky. If you need to accomplish this at home, you must be skilled and aware of the possible hazards of kickbacks. Then I bored holes for the screw placements. And then continue with the assembly. It was already evening. I normally schedule 1 to 2 hours of woodworking every day. I don't use glue but screw instead. Backup in case I need to upgrade later. I use double-sided adhesive to temporarily secure two sliders with sled. I double-check that the fence is perpendicular to the sled face, and that the sled face is perpendicular to the saw blade. Everything was exactly as expected. I will fix the two bottom rails with screws. The clamping equipment is complete. For cutting with 90 and 45 angles, as well as changing dado purpose, I make two pieces of wood. It will help me to adjust the width of the clearance between the sled and the saw blade. When building a sled, pay attention to the space between the sled face and the saw blade, as well as the distance between the saw blade and the fence bar. The narrower the distance, the less likely the wood will lose its edge. As I just said, this shield needs to be changed to fit the blade or dado to ensure minimum clearance. Next step, I will glue the ruler. The one I use has a measurement that increases from right to left. This is the step to install the extension bar. I test cut to make sure the stopper and ruler are correct. Both the ruler and the stopper are right. However, it appears that I will need to improve on dust collection. I need to get rid of any sharp edges. It helps me avoid being wounded when manipulating. And, as is customary, the next step is to apply a wood finish to make our tools more durable. I put wax on the bottom side to make it glide more smoothly. It's all for today. In the next video, I will do some more jigs for this sled. Thank you for watching and goodbye.